So this is a relatively young project that I started with a bunch of colleagues here, including Ganesh, who is with us right now. And so the main idea is to create a complaint management system where you can, you pose your complaint, and then we want to analyze the complaint so that we can route the complaint, of course, to the person who is supposed to handle the complaint, and many complaint management systems do that. But our main focus is to create a community around the set of people who have the same complaint, so that you can, in India, for example, solution providers is a scarce commodity. So if you want to optimize for that commodity, you want to sort of create joint representations, you want to reuse solutions, and all of that is possible if you have a fine-grained understanding of what is it that people are complaining about. So that is the thesis of this project, and these are some of the complaint management systems which we later discovered exists. When we started, we thought, oh, why we are going to do social good by being the first ones to build this kind of complaint management systems. But in Bangalore itself, there is this amazing website, ichangemycity.com, and they have a huge amount of data, and it's, I think, a very vibrant and useful system. But I think even that system just connects the complaint to BBMP or whoever else is solving the problem, but it does not try to aggregate complaints which talk about the same problem. And worldwide also, in fact, Indian Railways has a very vibrant complaint management system oriented around Twitter. So these are things which we discovered later. Whereas, this VentEr, we tried to kind of create communities around people who have the same complaints. So in terms of AI, we are solving very different problems than what is solved when you're doing complaint routing. When you're doing complaint routing, there is a fixed set of departments. There's a water department, the transport department, the health department. You essentially take the complaint and route it to the respective department. It is an easy coarse-grained classification problem. Well, not that easy, but relatively easy. Whereas what we want to do is actually understand the specific thing that is bothering a person in a particular geography. So basically, every complaint is a triple of time, location, and the specific problem. And we want to create, sort of connect all people who match on this triple, on this triplet. So to do achieve this fine-grained understanding, of course, we will need a lot of AI. There are many challenges. Complaints these days are largely images. People just take a photograph from their mobile and they just upload it. Look at this traffic violation. Look at this manhole. But of course, we sometimes also have text. So understanding complaints from this very sparse input is a challenge. And of course, in the Indian setting, we have noisy mixed language complaints, and the set of issues are evolving, unlike the set of departments. And that requires, again, fine-grained understanding of complaints. So the first step that we took towards putting some amount of structure to this task is to try to create an ontology. So our ontology has two players. One are the entities, and the other is the problem about that entity. So entities are not changing so fast. So we have roads, garbage, animals, street lights, but then the set of entities might change. Suddenly people might start complaining about drones, and rallies, of course, is a perpetual complaint issue. But when the system is built, you may not think about this. And then there are problems, things might be broken. You might ask for new roads or new street lights. And for garbage, you might want to talk about garbage not being collected. Animals might be stray. You might want to complain about stray animals or injured animals. But then you might discover new problems about existing entities, like about garbage. You might suddenly want to complain about the garbage collector asking money, asking bribes. About animals, pet poop, and things like that. So in all of this, when you think about AI, you think of lots of label data, but here we have no very little label data. And in fact, one reason to say democracy may not work in India, if you want to get depressed about democracy, you should look at the labels which are provided in these complaint management systems by people. Most of the labels are wrong. So you will have a lot of work in crowdsourcing. Okay. So basically what we try to do is, can we come up with shared subtasks which are trying to kind of solve an open-ended classification task without actually just sort of solving this first order task of finding a class label for a text. So the first shared task that we identified was a special kind of keyword extraction task, where given a marked entity in a sentence, you want to find out what is the problem that people are talking about that entity. So let me illustrate this with an example. So here are four complaints, and these are all complaints about garbage. So what we have marked in blue are the entities, and what we were trying to build is an extractor of complaints or problems about the entity. And this is what we are trying to build, a system, a keyword extractor, which is extracting snippets from the text which is identifying the problem. So garbage, auto not coming, very irregular, garbage vehicles parked on either side blocking the flow of traffic, garbage pickers taking the garbage. So from a routing point of view, these are all garbage complaints. But from our point of view, actually we see three communities here. So there is this blue community which is complaining about garbage not being collected regularly. There is this yellow community who is complaining about the garbage vehicle blocking the road. And then this new community which we would like to discover automatically, of the garbage pickers asking for money. So this is sort of the AI task that we are seeking to solve. And of course, here now, you know, for such tasks, we want to make use of continuous representations. And when you talk about continuous representations, then word embeddings comes to mind. So we are trying to use Word2Vec to embed both entities and the problem words in a continuous space, so that we can sort of put them in some space where proximity would mean relatedness. And so then the question is, since we have limited amount of training data, could we use some existing pre-trained resources? So Google generously has made put in open domain a word embedding corpus trained on 100 billion words. So we try to use those embeddings, and we find that those embeddings are actually not as good as the ones which we trained on just 25,000 complaints which we downloaded from I Change My City website. And here is an example of illustrating the difference. So dog in an embedding space trained on our corpus is close to stray, roaming, dead, filth and stray, whereas in the clean world of news, dog is close to animal, dogs, breed, cow, litter, all nice and dandy. Okay, so that's not the case in our corpus. Similarly, garbage, you know, we discover spelling mistakes like garage in our embedding space. Garbage and garage are in the same space, which you don't see in the word embedding. But of course, there will be, because of the limited corpus, there will be words where we will not get good embeddings. So this is an example of such a word. Congestion somehow is not trained well. So we are trying to figure out what is the best way to combine the two. And then we are trying to use these soft embeddings to do labeling automatically without label data, just by putting the class labels which are described in terms of keywords with keywords which appear in noisy text. And we put them both in a continuous space. And essentially, we're trying to learn a distance measure. Okay. And then finally, there are very exciting problems around relating text and image. So many complaints are just image only or text only complaints. So how do you relate them? How do you put a person who has uploaded an image only complaint with in the community of another person who has given a text only complaint? So for that, we try to co-embed text and image in the same continuous space. And there is no direct supervision again for that, but we had a nice idea of how we can take the few complaints which have both text and image and create automatic label data out of such complaints. So, and with that, we are able to find interesting things like, suppose if somebody has a text complaint of the form cows on the road, by putting this text, we have a sentence embedding, by putting this text in the same sort of in the co-embedding them with images, we are able to retrieve these image complaints, which although they happen to have some text attached to them, you find that the text has very little overlap with the words. Okay, so this is just more example, but in terms of status, I just want to end by saying that this is a system which we are really just only starting to build, and we would be very interested in talking to people who want to maybe take this further on the field. And we would like to talk to maybe companies like I Change My City, but if there are others that you know of, we will be happy to talk. Ganesh and I will, we are both hoping that this workshop will help us build some connections for this platform. Thanks.
Why you can't get users to provide input in somewhat structured format? Why are you starting with text and then?
Yeah, because you know people are, you know, you're out, you're about to get into your car, you see a pothole, you just want to take a picture and upload it. You don't want to be bothered by filling up forms.
So are there examples of the word embeddings looking across languages?
Yeah. Actually, oh, I could not get time to because he shooed me out. But but there was this example where we have kuda pada hai, and we could connect it to English complaints about garbage and all. So it is able to, yeah.